Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. In that, we are studying topic Structure of a Flower. We all have seen flower and we all know that it has different parts. Male gamete, female gamete, the corolla, petals. Today we'll be studying how are they formed, what are their functions. Structure of a flower. We all have seen a flower which is bright in color, smells very good, but do we know that flower has a lot of parts in it and those parts are very essential to the flower. Let's start one by one. What are those parts? The first part, petals, which are colorful, which attract either human beings or animals or butterfly for that matter towards the flower. Now petals are also termed as corolla. Whenever corolla is fused and sometimes corolla is individual, for example in rose, you can see that the corolla or petals are just removable, whereas in certain plants you cannot pick up a corolla or you cannot separate a corolla. So whenever there are two types of petals, or you can say corolla, one are polypetalous and another as gamopetalous. Now when I say gamopetalous, the corolla would be fused in such a manner that you cannot remove a single petal. Example is your China rose or sunflower, whereas polypetalous can be removed. The next part is the male gametophyte, or you can say androecium. Now this male gametophyte or androecium consists of anther and a filament, which is a stalk like thing, and inside this anther there are various pollen grains which are the male gamete. Next is the female gametophyte or the female reproductive tract. Now female reproductive tract basically has stigma, style and ovary. Stigma is a hollow passage through which pollen grains will gain entry. Style is just the passage through which pollen grains will adhile, or you can say they will adhere and move accordingly. Inside ovary there would be female gametes. So finally during pollination, male and female gamete meet together. Apart from that, inside a flower, or you can see just the outer surface of the flower, has some green color structure, and those are called as sepals, or you can say calyx. Now this sepals or calyx basically protect the flower in baby stage, or you can say when it is not growing properly, or you can say in the early growing phases. Calyx also makes sure that the flower is protected just in its growing ages when it has not blossomed properly. Beside that, there is a pedicel just to hold that flower. Now corolla attracts various pollinators like butterflies just for the pollination process. Some plants, along with having corolla and calyx, has perianth in them. Structure of a flower. Flower consists of calyx or corolla. Now calyx is the green part, or it is also called as sepals. This is a part that encloses the flower in bud stage or in the early growing phase. Corolla are known as petals and they help in pollinating, or they attract pollinators towards them. androecium, the male part. Now, this male gametophyte basically consists of anther and filament. Anther consists or contains pollen grains. Gynoecium is the female part, which is divided into stigma, style, and ovary. Some plants also have perianth region. This is the structure of flower. As you can see, these are petals, or you can say corolla. These are sepals, which are also called as calyx. And this is the stem region. This is the male gametophyte. Now the male gametophyte will have anther and filament. Together they are called as stem, or you can say androecium or male gametophyte. Whereas your female gametophyte is called as carpel, pistil, or gynoecium. It is divided into three different parts. Stigma, where the pollen grains will enter. Style, the hollow passage. And the ovary, inside which ovules would be present, or you can say the female egg would be present. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about the structure of a flower and its various parts. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.